you stand, please? Thank you. You may be seated. We've gathered today to celebrate the life of Charles Eugene Davis, Jr., to celebrate his life, to remember the life that he lived. We gather too with broken hearts to do our grief work to the end that we might discover both courage and comfort. And we gather too to worship the living God, the one who is Lord of life and of death, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Begins with death. I am Take my hand, Lord, lead me home.
One of Charles's favorite scriptures is from John chapter 11. From that chapter, we have the story of Lazarus being raised from the grave. And this passage, I understand, was the anchor for Charles's faith. Here are some select verses from John 11. Verse 11. These things said Jesus, and after that he saith unto them, Our friend Lazarus sleepeth, but I go that I may awake him out of sleep. Further down in verse 17. Then when Jesus came, he found that Lazarus had lain in the grave 4 days already. In verses 20 through 25. Then Martha, as soon as she heard that Jesus was coming, went and met him, but Mary was still in the house. Then said Martha unto Jesus, Lord, if thou hast been here, my brother had not died. But I know that even now, whatsoever thou wilt ask of God, God will give it thee. Jesus saith unto her, Thy brother shall rise again. And Martha said unto him, I know that he shall rise again in the resurrection at the last day. But Jesus said to her, I am the resurrection and the life. He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. And whosoever liveth and believeth in me shall never die. Believest thou this? She saith unto him, Yea, Lord, I believe that thou art the Christ, the Son of God, which should come into the world. May God bless this, his word, for your comfort. Will you pray with me this afternoon? Almighty God, you love everything you've made, and you judge us with infinite mercy and justice. We rejoice in your promises of pardon, joy, and peace to all those who love you. In your mercy, we pray that you turn the sorrow of parting into the very joy of heaven. Through our Savior, Jesus Christ, who died, rose again, and lives forevermore, we make our prayer. And amen. Thank you. Well, again, we've gathered to honor the memory of Charles Eugene Davis, Jr., who lived to the age of 80. He was a beloved member of the community, owner of Davis Enterprise for many years, and he died October the 19th at his residence. After serving honorably in the Army, Charles led a fulfilling life, dedicating himself to his work, acquiring license in the fields of electrician, plumber, and well driller. And after years of hard work and commitment, he retired, leaving behind a legacy of professionalism and expertise. His involvement in various organizations showcased his dedication to the community. He was four-time past master of the Currituck Lodge 463, proud member of the Elizabeth City York Rite Bodies. These affiliations demonstrate his commitment to fellowship and service. As you know, he was a very giving man, a man filled with charity. Is there anyone who may have a memory you might like to share of Charles? If you do, we'd prefer you come forward. We're being live streamed today that so that others who are not here may be able to view. Anyone? When Charles's mother died, he wrote a poem to be read at her funeral, and the family has asked me to share that with you today. What will they say about me, those whom I hold so dear? What will they best remember when I'm no longer here? Will they recall mistakes I've made, battles I never won, moments of pain I've caused them, things I've left undone? Will they censor my human failings and wish I'd been noble and strong? Will they scoff at the hopes I'd nurtured, the dreams that somehow went wrong? Or will they be moved by compassion, directed from heaven above, to temper their judgment with kindness and soften their memories with love?
Thank you.
I wasn't acquainted with Charles as some of you were throughout his lifetime, or maybe just in recent years, but from the obituary and the few words I've shared with you, one thing really stands out to me, and that was he served in the Army. I served 4 years in the Air Force, and it seemed like a lifetime. But when I asked Tammy about there being any kind of military honors, the volley of the weapons, the bugle, she said no. But he didn't want any of that. He felt like what he did for his country was his service. Boy, that speaks quantity of any person. Now, we read to you earlier from John 11 about the Martha being so upset with her brother Lazarus and the promise that Jesus gave her that he, Lazarus, and all who believe in Christ would live again. So just a couple chapters later, the disciples were really concerned about this afterlife, and Jesus spoke from John 14, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. But I go and prepare a place for you, that where I am, there you may be also." I want to speak for a few moments about this heavenly place. Repeatedly in the book of Revelation, chapter 21, the Lord says he's making something new. And the Bible uses two words that are rendered new in our English vocabulary. One of those words emphasizes something that's new in time, like a car, maybe. The second word is the one used here, and it describes something that is new in the dimension of quality. Our heavenly home will sparkle with the best of everything. We just can't imagine how new it will be. More than new, it's designed by the finest architect, built by the best contractor. Jesus said, again, "I'm going to prepare a place for you," in Hebrews 11:10, "that where I am, there you may be." Now, Hebrews says that the saints of old dreamed of this city with foundations, whose architect and builder is God. So we come to understand then that our heavenly home will be spacious, and Revelation emphasizes more the size of the city than the individual residences that are therein. The New Jerusalem, as John named it, is described as a cube 1,500 miles wide and tall and deep. Now, even I suspect that that is merely symbolic for something on a scale that is beyond our imagination. You recall that ancient walled cities were small, often more like large forts or castles, and only the rulers and the military and the very rich people lived in the city proper. Most folks lived outside the walls, but in times of danger or invasion, everyone would leave their homes and head to the city for protection. But this city, heaven, we're talking about, is big enough for everyone to live inside the walls. It defies description. We're told the foundations are marked with jewels of untold value, pearls form each of the 12 gates, and the streets are paved with gold. But the most important feature there, as I made reference to earlier, will be the quality of life, something we all look forward to. I've been battling with a condition for the last 10, 11 months. While I'm looking forward for a better quality of living in this life, certainly in the next. But heaven abounds with the tree of life, and we're told that the river of life flows from the throne of God. John the Revelator tells us sickness and diseases are gone. God himself, we're told, is going to wipe away every tear. And so consequently, there will be no more death, mourning, crying, or pain. The throne of God and of the Lamb will be in the city, and we, his servants, will serve him, fulfilling the very purpose for which you and I were created. My prayer today is that you share that same faith that Charles had and others who are believers, because it is our only hope for an eternity whereby we may be in the presence of God. May God bless these words for your comfort and hope. Following the final prayer, the family is going to be ushered into the lobby, so you'll have an opportunity to greet them, and the funeral home staff will usher you at that time. Let us now receive words of committal. Under the mercy of Almighty God, we commend the soul of Charles Eugene Davis, Jr. Commit his body to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, and dust to dust, in the sure and certain hope of the resurrection from the dead, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Will you bow with me for prayer? Lord, we believe that you watch over all things, and you care for all things, from the greatest to the least. As we prepare to go from this place, I pray that you will multiply your grace, your mercy and peace upon this family and their friends, so that we shall all know the comfort of your presence in our lives. And now I ask you to join me as we pray aloud, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. And amen.
Thank you. Thank you.